Real Talk Radio.
Reading is feeding the mind. Feed the mind. Go to udarabooks.com. Udara Books, feeding the mind.
State Affairs with Edmond Obilo is live. Stay tuned.
Well, he has a problem after the primary with Falahi.
Yes.
And he was not elected. And he believed he should have been elected.
What happened that day? How was Falahi selected?
We put up a primary for the presidency in the party. And it was made open. And we constituted a primary board. We chose members from all over the country. The members of the party who have chosen my office in Lagos. Are you listening?
I'm with you, sir.
But like you was there. Then Paul also raised the question that you are one of the people this body, it's not right for you to be here with us to choose who are going to examine you. Because we wanted to choose the people who go consume the electoral body. He said no. Because he's the deputy leader of the party, he has to be there. Then Tinubu, I only hope you will remember, said even in company, if you're a member of the board, you have an interest in the matter, you leave the board for discussion. That is his contribution. He still insisted. When he said that I must stay, Papa and our leader then,
Adesanya,
overruled. Said, all right, what does it stay? So we started to nominate names. In the course of nominating names, we nominated this man from militia, the blue man, Lawrence Somali. But like he objected. It was his objection of Lawrence Somali that we now put in Professor Kemi. Kemi is still alive. I hope you know that he participated in members of the electoral body that was going to do the things.
Was Falahi there too?
No. And in that electoral college, neither myself, nor Paul Adesanya, nor Lani Wajai, none of us were members of the electoral college. And electoral college, Bola Ige had an advantage of about five or six of his former commissioners who are members because they have already been elected as governors. And even the chairman of that electoral body, late Palayode, was a commissioner under him. So he had an handicap of about five people against Falahi. And in fact, he told people that out of the 23 people there, he already got about 13 or 14 people who will vote for him.
So he was confident he was going to win.
I know that about that. He was confident. As a matter of fact, when later, after he became member of Obasanjo's cabinet, and myself, Adesanya, and the late Oni had an audience with Obasanjo. Obasanjo put up the question that, but like he said, he was not elected because the election took place when he was away out of the country. I said, that would not be fair. I said, it's in your cabinet. When he was going on that tour, Papa, this was asking, suppose those who want to do the election want to see you pass. He said, no, he said he had a medical reason to go. He said, okay. And I told him, so you had that interview. He's still in your cabinet. Go and ask him whether that is true or not. That was what happened.
So when he lost, how did he feel?
If we don't, you see, even and your first on me is still alive. He announced, he was a member of the electoral college. He announced the result. You see, the pressure today, and I hope many people will be listening now, Maybe we will be surprised the way I'm talking like that. I was not a member of the Electoral College because I was regarded as the main opponent of Bola Ige.
Were you his opponent?
Never. This is a misconception.
Misconception. Where did that come from?
You shouldn't ask me. It is those who have that. We are good friends. When we were in Ibadan, I stay in his house whenever I come to him to there.
Did he believe you were one of those who worked against him?
He believes so, and I tell you why. Before the election, we had a meeting in Kaduna. We had a meeting of the AG. In fact, we stayed in his wife's house. There was a judge of the Supreme Court, of the Court of Appeal. And he asked us that he was going to contest the election. I asked myself, at this one, and then he said that we should support you. And I told him, I can't support you. I am the chairman of the party. Will it be fair for me to support the candidate against the other when I'm the person to which the report will be brought to? Our Lord didn't teach us that way. So he's doing that. Not that I was supposed to. I only said that on principle.
But would you have loved that he emerged as the presidential
candidate? He's qualified. He's qualified. I only leave it to the democracy people to do, the body to elect. But for me to give an advance, I mean, would you say that would be fair?
Chief Adebanjo, yeah. What happened during that election?
I wouldn't know. You should ask those who are there.
Did you ask them? Because Bolaige was sure he was going to win.
Look.
So what happened? How did he lose that election? Because Yoruba land has not recovered from the crisis that emanated from that election.
It all depends upon how you look at it. You see, the young men and his admirers have their view. Those of us who are in the show, we know what happened.
What happened?
Yeah, that what happened was that there's a misconception, in my view, on the part of Bola Ige. And I said, those whom he said would vote for him that electoral college, how did he start him become dying or something? He should have asked himself. He told some people that, well, I'm going to win. I know one of the people I knew he told was Ambassador Fora Fafora. He told me. I've said this one in an interview before in the paper when he was still alive. That said, oh, he was going to win. I said, well, that was his conception. I don't know what gave him that impression.
Well, at a point, there was this feeling that top Afenifere elders like you felt serve him well. He's too overconfident.
Look. You heard what people are suggesting. You see, what you don't know in our own Afenifere, we are very free. And on an occasion, I think Dari Babarisa and others, they were the body who said they want to settle. Are you listening?
I'm listening.
He said, I want to settle differences between me and Bola Ige. We had a meeting at Yebubu. And he was making accusations against members of the party. When he came to us, he said, he doesn't even know what he has done for me. And I said, I know what I have done. I always criticize you. Where I don't agree with you, I'll tell you openly, you know. Where others will pretend, I don't pretend. When you do anything wrong, I tell you. I said, that's all. No other thing. Well, the conception of people about parties and about friendship is quite different. The way I know about good relationship should be on principle and honesty.
Did the leadership of AD and Afenifere at the time try to pacify him?
Why should he? He's a Democrat, isn't he? We all agree on the method of selecting candidates.
Did he take that loss graciously?
You should not ask me that question. You should ask him. We all agree. And I told you now that he participated in the names of those who formed the Electoral College. Now, are you saying he can approbate and reprobate? If he's a Democrat, does it mean that the body is took part in setting up? If he believed, because the claim was making later, which you people don't know that, because he was the deputy leader, he should have been chosen automatically. Once that didn't happen, and you agreed you are going to set up an electoral college, and you subjected yourself to that electoral college. If you are a Democrat, why should you be opposed to the result?
Chief Ayo Adebanjo is my guest. We are walking down history lane.
Bush Radio, the home of history.
Reading is feeding the mind. Feed the mind. Go to udarabooks.com. Udara Books, feeding the mind.
State Affairs with Edmond Obilo is live. Stay tuned.
After that election, Bola Ige did not win. Olufalai did not win the presidential election either. At what point did Afenifere start breaking up?
Well, unfortunately, Bola Ige didn't react well. As a result of losing that election, he made up his mind to break the party and form a section to join Obasanjo. As a matter of fact, when we were conducting the case against Obasanjo, and the chairman were in Abuja, Sabi Laluko of the present memory sought us with our lawyers in the Abuja and came to us and said, "Why are you bothering yourself? Your deputy has already accepted ministerial appointment under Obasanjo." It was for him we first of all heard about it.
Were you shocked?
I was shocked, of course, because I have not been told. Not only that, it will interest you to know that when Obasanjo won, he made the pronunciation, the pronouncement that he was going to form a unity government by inviting every political parties. Okay? If you are going to form by inviting every political party, you will write to the political parties to give you candidates. Because that was the beginning of my disagreement with those who believe I was opposed to it. I can admit that I've been guilty of sticking to ideas and principles.
And you are blunt to a fault.
Very, very, very blunt. Well, when I go to DC, and Bola Ige was alive, I tell people, I've never had any quarrel with anybody on election, either party election or electoral. Never. And I've never held any public office there. Even the acting leader I had was as a result of the man who was our chairman, who at the nick of time left us. But people will believe that was Obasanjo who bought one man from this. And we were close to the election, the party said it. You just act. I have never had a position which I contest with anybody. So the point I'm trying to make is that ideas by which we learn from Charo Law is very strict. You call a spade, and you go by certain standard. He didn't take kindly to his losing the election. And when Obasanjo now asked him to come to the left, he didn't consult us. Some leaders of the party felt that was wrong because Alaunde came to me. I said, "Why don't you support us?" I said, "We are not aware about his appointment. And if Obasanjo wants a coalition government or whatever he calls it, it will be the party we support. He has no right to nominate for us."
Perhaps Obasanjo just saw him as a leader of the party.
No way. Don't read it. You listen to my own story. Why Obasanjo did what he did? You go and ask him. I'm telling you what happened and why I opposed it. Whether I saw him as a leader or not, but he said he wants to invite all political parties. He does not say he's going to nominate. It's just that what the Northerners did by choosing Obasanjo to as a Yoruba man. So when that one happened, and they chose him, and they said they should come and settle palaver between me and he asked them, what did he? He didn't know what he did for me, and I told him, because I tell you what, where you go wrong. So when after his appointment now, and Papa Laonde was asking us that we should support, I said, well, we can only support him if he says he believes that the party exists and take permission. Then Laonde says to come and tell us that he has been appointed.
So did he do that?
He came later on. After I said he has been appointed. And I said, I didn't like my feelings. If Obasanjo wanted to form a coalition, or what you would call it at that time, I will not choose Bolaji to him at that cabinet.
You made that statement?
Oh, yes, they know. I tell you, you see, that's why I say when people talk, they don't know that the member of the party knew. Because I tell them, when people ask me, say, what right has Obasanjo to come and tell another party this is the man must be? If the all parties want to form, it is that party we give a candidate. So all I'm saying is, my whole reasoning now is what I want people to criticize, not what people should be.
Or who would you have nominated?
Eh?
Who would you have nominated?
Oh, I would nominate the lesser person, because I consider the cabinet of Obasanjo at that time as top class.
So Bolaige was too big for
too
that cabinet?
Too big for that. So
you feel he belittled himself?
Yeah, one, not only that, he was going to lend credibility to Obasanjo's government. Everybody will have his own prejudice. But I want to give them the advice that they should hear from me before they crucify me. Because many people thought that, oh, he didn't want to go, but he wanted, no. I said, is that cabinet, is your equipment there? Those are your class, that is your class. I don't want to embarrass anybody. Who are the people formed? You know who formed the cabinet of Obasanjo at that time. Are they the caliber of Obasanjo? And my own view is that the way we were, as said at that time, if we hold ourselves strong like that, Obasanjo's government won't last 6 months.
So do you blame
Bola? I blame Bola for weakening our stand to support an opponent.
And AD never recovered.
Of course. Not only that, when he got there, he now started to work against the party to divide us. You see, somebody was saying, yes, I know that was Bolaige that helped Obasanjo Yoruba support. And he mentioned to some of the members that he was split the Afenifere and the AD. The remedy, we made them join the Obasanjo government to see the government. And this is replete, and I want you journalists to go and do this research. Many of us whom we know what time we had, we are not happy that he joined Obasanjo's government, because we knew what we have said against Obasanjo and what he, in particular, has said against Obasanjo. And we knew Obasanjo is not forgiving.
Chief Adebanjo, do you feel at this moment that Ige decided to join that government in order to spite us?
Of course, that is it. Not that I feel. Anybody who knows, it's just to spite us that well. And if I, in fact, allow him, they said in one of the meetings that when we don't allow him to be president and they want to appoint him, they do to support him. And I said, yes, but on principle. You see, all those who are talking about sentiment and a lot of his friends, you are going to another life, because if by the time he died, a lot of stories were being told. That was the leaders of the Afenifere that killed him. And guy that has been funny. Those of us who are not in government, we now organize the assassination of somebody whom the government gave 6 security people. And instead of looking inwards at that time, if they did, they would have known who killed him. And that pained me.
Those of who were the suspects?
Many people knew. Don't ask me that question on the radio. We are all in this country.
Do you feel he was eliminated so that somebody would capture the Southwest?
Whatever it is, we knew his killing has some authority support. And our own reason is this. How can the chief law officer of the country with six security people attached to him be killed the way Bolaji was killed? Those who are talking about this, they don't want to say what injury we have. And the six people left is the man we are killing to go and eat. My dear, you follow all this is because people are just talking about sentiment, your prejudice. And they still say, because they are disagreeing with his leaders, those are people killing and just laugh. That is one. Two, Samomanche Omoshe, he wrote an article after his death that if Bolaji has remained loyal to his group, he would not have died at the time he died. And if he died at that time, he would not die the way he died. It was Samomanche who wrote that article in The Nation. It is an important thing I want you to go and do research to. Because when you research outside that, Samomanche is a supporter of opposition, you go and all that. Read the context of the whole article. Because those are the journalists who are following Israel at that time. He must have his reason for writing that way. I don't know him. Him to have written that article, that the way he died was, he wouldn't have died at the time.
Did the leaders of Afenifere and AD see that tragedy coming?
Yes, because we knew the ambassador didn't like him.
You knew?
Yes. And in fact, Pahadesoya had information from somebody when, as well as I just said, he was going to draw him near to knock him. But like he said, very serious things against Obasanjo before. Only people just don't know. And when he heard that, by the time that it was too late for us to tell Bolaji, be careful, this is what we heard this man say.
Did the leadership of AD abandon him when he became a member of the Obasanjo government?
No, he was still coming to our party. Only with the only disagree, see, in our own way, in our own political party, the First Republic, we fire through the mouth, we don't shoot ourselves. If you read the disagreement between Aolo and Aziku and Akitola, you'll be surprised about what they say. But that is the end of the matter. It is these days that they started to kill themselves. That tradition of the present generation.
Chief Adebanjo, how was Bola Ege able to attract Tinubu to his side?
Well, that is still part of the game to weaken AD. He knows that all these governors want to lead. He was that attraction. And that when we sit down today, it was Bola Ege, Tinubu, and Obasanjo that decimated AD and Afenifere. That is it. He used them, that he was supporting them, that don't listen to the party leaders. And so they cling on to him.
Was Bola Ege behind the formation of the Yoruba Council of Elders?
More or less. We need that later. Because let me tell you, even Thompson, who was the leader, and you can confirm this from Ayo Opadoku. We were coming from somewhere, I will call that Thompson's place in the Bado. And Thompson then told us that he was trying to form a Yoruba Council of Elders. And we told him, no use proliferating Yoruba organization. If there's anything wrong with Afenifere, come in there and rectify it. The unity of Yoruba land can't be solidified, can't be concreted by organizing various types of organization. And said he agreed. And all the papers of the council that he gives for Akwadoku. That aspect, I challenge you to go and confirm from Akwadoku still alive, because he was the secretary of Afenifere at that time.
But he still went ahead to...
He still went ahead. And to show you, no sooner they formed Council of Elders, he led them to come and greet Obasanjo in Asoroka. That is why they didn't hide their support later. And we are carrying on.
How come Afeniferi at the time did not realize to a very large extent that that group was going to be decimated?
My dear, it takes two to dance tango. Are you listening? Fortunately, yeah, Bishop Borig is still around, and some other people, and the late Justice Esho, they're still around, who try to mediate. You can ask Borig how many times they summoned the Tinubu group and all that, they didn't come. We are ready.
What was their demand?
Well, they just want to be the leadership. What demand?
They wanted elders like you to sit back and watch.
We can't even be the forgotten, and they don't want anybody, but I mean a group of people to who they will report to, that's all.
Lama Dishino was also part of the...
Of course! All the five governors, except the governor of Ondo State at that time.
Adi Farati.
And partly we suspect at that time that Oshoba was not completely with them, but even later on, that's not for this radio.
Why is it not for this radio?
No, because one thing will lead to the other, because I don't want to say a thing.
Because we need to hear from elders like you.
For this radio, that was what happened.
Tinubu,
if I tell you that he's completely with them, I won't be correct. If I tell you he was completely with us, I won't be correct. That is what. Why that is, that's why I say it's not for this radio.
At the end of the day,
he didn't like it, because we often say that during that crisis, that Afeniferi leadership, we only have the support of 1.5 governors.
And Oshoba was the half.
He complained to me that they say I'm half. I said, well, don't say you are half. They only say 1.5 governors. How are you sure that you are the half?
Bush Radio.
Bush Radio.
Bush Radio.
Bush, Bush, Bush.
Bush Radio.
Your real talk radio.